This chip is going to change everything.
Please, sir.
What is it, Blue One?
We got everything under control here. But I do want to go on the record of saying I never liked it, not one bit.
You've got your orders. Do your job and we'll be fine.
Yeah, right.
In 60 seconds, his heart rate will be high enough. Then we can begin.
Blue One, what's going on?
We got company, Blue Team, east side!
I need more time to implant the chip.
I don't care! Do something! Can you see where they're tech here? It's all over. Blue One.
Prices continued to tumble.
Lehman Brothers was forced to declare itself bankrupt.
I think what we see in society today is a result of Christians being apathetic and complacent.
The largest single point drop.
And you're selling everything, even at a loss, just to get out of the market.
Many put high on their list, but is the Christian faith now losing ground in America?
Unity is collapsing under the pressure, leading only to chaos and confusion.
And the uncoordinated moves by European leaders has added uncertainty.
Demonstrators are angry about the government's handling of the country's economic crisis and soaring unemployment.
The percentage of people who call themselves Christians has dropped by 10% in a generation.
The exchange dropped more than a heart-stopping 1,000 points in early trading, its biggest drop ever.
The Prime Minister is now facing a motion of censure in the Parliament from the opposition, which claims soldiers used excessive force.
Many Christians believe it's the wake-up call. Hundreds gathered to pray for America and the faith.
Soon, vicious battles were breaking out across the city.
Around the world, stock markets continued their terrifying plunge.
More violence remains a distinct possibility.
The economic woes of America and the economic woes of many other economies of the world, the great push is going to be toward a global one world.
Thanks to a microchip under your skin, it's all there. Science fiction 20 years ago, but a biometric reality today.
The Avanti Corporation announced today it has begun testing its first human implant.
Just announced this week that he wants to see a new financial condition in the world. And he also says, I want to see a one-world government led by a one-world leader.
It wasn't what you thought it was going to be. Okay, so you're done. I mean, at least you're done with it, you know?
Yeah, but that's not what it's about, though.
Well, what is? You served your country, and honorably, I might add.
I took a bullet, and I got a little purple heart.
For God and country?
I'll tell you one thing, I didn't see a whole lot of God over there. And don't talk to me about Lord works in mysterious ways. I don't want to hear that.
You know, everybody has their own purpose in life, Chad. And everything happens for a reason. It's all part of the big picture, man.
What big picture?
When he reveals it, then we'll know.
Little brother, you got your God and you got your religion, and I respect that. I really do, but that's not the real world.
Welcome back. Name's Cooper. I work for Avante, the company that hired your team to run security for us.
What happened? I'm still a little bit foggy.
What happened is you just became a very valuable man.
So what am I, Superman now?
Sort of. It wasn't supposed to happen this way, Mr. Turner, but it did. Because of that, you're able to earn in one job what might take your entire career.
Okay, I'm listening.
The G20 summit happens in Berlin next week. I need that chip to arrive there safely.
So you need to get me there safely?
You and that chip are connected, forever linked.
So what's the plan?
Commercial flight in 2 days. We hide in plain sight.
This is the most authoritative accounting to date of Lehman's collapse and pretty much of any firm that experienced the trauma of the financial crisis. What were the biggest surprises to you?
What surprised me was the fact that you were so late in terms of bringing down the balance sheet. The comments about shrinking Lehman's balance sheet really...
I am the way, and the truth, and the life.
Do you know how many languages are spoken today?
No. But I'm sure you're about to enlighten me.
There used to be one. Grunting and hand signals. Primitive, but it worked. Now there's over 100 different ways to say the same thing. Does it make any sense to you?
Changes the nature of life. A mankind will always do what it needs to ensure its own survival.
But that's just it. It's not working. It's falling apart. Too many nations, too many currencies, too much fighting, and too much sickness. Masses are beginning to rally against hunger, unemployment, and poverty. Everything is out of balance. Something has to change. The world is in chaos. Our religious leaders say it is the end of the world, and other gibberish like the rapture. Obviously, the world is in desperate need of a savior. And I have the answer. I intend to be that savior.
I have no interest in your politics or your opinion. The only thing that concerns me is that I successfully complete the job you pay me to do. So what is it you need from me?
A new technology has emerged. A microchip designed by the Avante Corporation. I offered to buy it. They refused. It's being transported by plane from Bangkok to Berlin. I want you to bring it to me.
You know my price. I want 50% up front, and I'm going to need 500,000 euros for operating costs.
All taken care of. It was your mark.
We'll be in touch.
Sir, we need to scan you.
Thanks, Dal. See you on board.
Good evening. Nice to see you again, Mr. Turner.
Oh, hey, Dal. How have you been? It's good to see you, too.
Are you here to see your father?
No, actually, I'm just here doing some business.
Okay, sir. You are clear.
So you're gonna be first class, right?
Dal!
I think I have to go now, so I'm gonna see you on board.
He's cute, Dal. Who's that?
Welcome aboard Flight 417, ladies and gentlemen. We'll be flying at 30,000 feet, and it will take roughly 12 hours to get to Berlin. We hope you'll enjoy the flight. Thank you for flying Trans-Pacific Airways.
What would you like to drink?
Nothing for me, thanks.
Hey, where's Jen?
Hi, guys. Oh, wow, nice to see you too, Ted.
You're gonna have to cut him some slack tonight, darling.
Why? No.
Sure, Ted.
Here it is.
Wow, that is beautiful. Where? When? Details, details. Well, you're not gonna do it during drink service, I hope.
No. well, I thought I would take her for a moonlight stroll. Ending up at that bridge, you know, the one that she loves in East Berlin?
Oh, sounds perfect.
Yeah, I hope so.
Why can't I meet someone decent here?
Hey, I introduced you two first.
Oh, that is true.
True. Lost your chance.
Congratulations.
Thanks.
Okay, I'm out of here, boys.
All right. Remember, mum's a word.
How are you?
Hello again, Mr. Turner. Anything assassin?
Please. Long flight, huh? Thank you.
So, how long ago did he die?
It's been years now.
Time really doesn't make a difference, though, does it?
Excuse me.
You still serving?
Yes, what can I get you?
What do you got?
Pineapple juice.
Ooh, yummy. That sounds good. I'll have what he's having.
Okay, sure.
So, you and your buddy over there take this route often?
My buddy?
Yeah, excuse me.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Sure you do. Guy over there, sitting right behind you. You like her, don't you?
Who?
Her. Deo.
It's Dao.
Oh.
That way.
I'm Jody, by the way.
Chad.
So, you guys are with Avanti, aren't you? You and your buddy over there that keeps looking over at the one you're not with. It's my job to know when people are hiding something. I'm guessing you're what, security?
What are you, a detective?
Journalist.
I should have known.
There.
Good. You got 5 minutes.
So you want to know how I know you're with Avanti, Chad?
I'm just dying, Jody.
Your buddy's watch. Last year, Avanti's top 20 executives were awarded an $80,000 Patek Philippe watch. And your buddy over there? He's wearing one.
Hmm. All that really proves is that you need to get yourself a hobby or maybe a boyfriend.
Both true facts, but far from the point. The point is, I know that the G20 summit is next week in Berlin, and I know that Avanti is supposed to make some kind of big announcement there, so I'm willing to bet that that is where you are going.
Radios.
Hurry up, Jerry.
So, Cap, where did you get engaged?
It was after a singles volleyball game, and we were in the back of a Volkswagen Bug.
No way.
Yeah.
That's not very romantic.
No, I'm not very good at that. You know Jen's a Christian.
Yeah, of course.
How are you going to handle that?
Yeah, I know. I guess we just, you know, we don't really talk about it.
You should talk about it.
Do you think so?
I do.
I'm going to get a coffee.
Give her a kiss for me. And get me a ginger ale.
Okay. Don't you see what's happening? This summit is just a smokescreen for what's really going on.
All right, Julie. Just tell me what's really going on.
Our financial system is collapsing into a global power grab by the wealthy bankers, politicians, and big business. Think European Union, only much bigger. The entire world under a single currency, a single bank, and eventually, a single leader.
Are we talking about Satan?
Here, go back up.
So you have read the Bible.
Yeah.
When you know how this lays out, you've got to admit this looks a lot like the beginning of the end. It looks a lot like the tribulation.
Look, to me,
another book.
How can you say that?
Because I live in reality. Excuse me.
Hurry up! Hurry up!
Are you lost? Copper Sedgwick.
No, actually, I was just...
Do you know where I can get any more of the... Oh, hi. Okay, I'm out of here.
Well, hurry up.
I'm behind schedule.
I've reached avionics. I'm going in.
Excuse me, would you like something to drink?
Coffee, please.
Okay.
What happened is you just became a very valuable man.
I know that the G20 summit is next week in Berlin, and I know that Avanti is supposed to make some kind of big announcement there, so...
You two. Who's flying the plane and who's tending to the passengers?
No, I didn't.
Isn't it beautiful?
Oh.
What? I couldn't wait. What do you want from me? I was burning a hole in my pocket.
Absolutely gorgeous. Thank you.
Congratulations, guys.
Ladies and gentlemen, I have an announcement to make.
No, don't.
We are currently cruising at 34,000 feet, and flight time is approximately...
Altimeter set.
All right. Just wait for my signal.
Oh, excuse me.
No problem.
Stop! I just got engaged.
Yes, congratulations.
Thanks. I'd give you a cigar, but it's a non-smoking flight.
Isn't that for a baby?
What?
A cigar.
Ah, yeah, you're right. Yeah, no, we're not there yet.
Did I hear engagement?
Yeah, just happened.
That's great. Hey. Thanks. I'm an ordained minister, if you all want to get it out of the way here on the plane.
Excuse me.
Oh, yes, sure. Yeah, of course. Yeah, you know what? I don't think that she would go for that, like, at all. But thank you.
Everybody has their own purpose in life, Chad. And everything happens for a reason. All life has meaning and purpose. It all does. You know, the Bible says, blessed are those who read and hear the prophecy and take it to heart, because the time is near.
Little brother, I've seen the horrors of war. Watched a 12-year-old girl take a bullet. Died right there in my arms, okay? Why would God let an innocent child die like that?
Death of a child is... it's always a tragic event, man. It always is.
Well, let me guess, you got an answer for me, right? Because you always have an answer for everything.
No, not everything. This one? I think I do.
Really?
Yeah.
Enlighten me.
You know, I believe the child's purpose was to ensure that you survived. She took that bullet that was meant for you in order for you to live out your purpose in life.
I didn't see you there. Can I help you with something?
Ginger ale.
Looking for something, Ted?
Oh, hey, Dad. Yeah, ginger ale for the cap.
Oh, it's back there. Hang on. Jennifer? Jennifer, are you back there? Let me just go get it for you, okay?
Okay, thanks.
Stop that flight attendant.
Excuse me?
I see the one go back.
Hey!
Evening.
Just got engaged.
Hey, that's great. Who's the lucky lady?
Stewardess. Maybe you've seen her. She's brunette, big smile, beautiful.
Can't say I have, but congrats anyway.
Thank you.
A change of plan. Activate Gemma.
Ted, you back there?
Hey, Cap. We seem to be having trouble with the ginger ale.
We seem to be having problems with the radio.
You better get back up here.
Aye, aye.
You are the air marshal, right?
I'm sorry, I don't know what you're talking about.
I know you're armed, so you're either the air marshal or a real problem.
When the cockpit door opens, we'll move.
Steady. Steady.
Yep. You got trouble.
Sir, can I talk to you for a second?
Stop him.
Everybody stay in your seats and shut up!
Everybody report.
Is the plane secure?
Coach is secure.
Co-pilot just had a little accident, but he's about to help me get into the cockpit. Get him out of here.
Get up! Let's go!
Now!
Up!
Captain won't open the door.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah, that's right. I know him.
But you don't know me, do you?
Jerry.
You still there?
I'm here. What happened?
Yeah, there's been a little
setback up here. Need some explosive up here ASAP. Hang on. Let's see if we can do this the easy way first. Get your wine and you ain't gonna die. Head Scott. It is Ted, right? You do realize that with or without your assistance, I am going to get into this cockpit.
Jerry.
Captain! Have I got your attention? You see this?
This is a high-powered gelatin explosive.
Strong enough to blow this door off of its hinges. Now that's the good news. The bad news is that it might take out most of us at the same time.
So I suggest you open this door if you want to stop anybody else from getting hurt.
Now unless you cooperate, people out here are going to start dying. Has anyone found the mark?
No, sir. We're still looking, but there's no sign of them.
That's impossible. Graham, go get one of the flight attendants. Now. Is there anywhere else on this plane somebody could be hiding? I said, is there anywhere else on this plane someone could hide?
No. No, there's nowhere else.
What is it?
Our package has gone missing. We may have joined you down there.
Captain?
This is the captain. Who is this?
This is the man that's taken over your plane.
Listen, I'm the captain, and I'm still in control of this plane.
For now, you can follow a few simple instructions, it'll stay that way.
I don't want anyone getting hurt.
Getting hurt. I just need you to change altitude.
I'm not flying this plane into any building.
I'm a businessman, Captain. I'm not a suicide bomber. Look, this is the easiest choice you're ever gonna have to make in your life.
Do it.
And I won't be forced to kill anybody else.
Anyone else?
I'll kill you!
It was unavoidable. Captain, you're gonna do as I say. He wants to talk to you.
I'm sorry.
I found the package. You want me to send it off?
Just make sure it's secure.
Well, I got what I came for. Now it's up to you.
And I want the lights on.
Captain, can you please level out the plane?
Did it work? Did it work?
Yeah, it worked, Captain. But now I'm mad.
Get down! Get down, please!
Hook this up so I can talk to the passengers. Hook this thing up so I can talk to the passengers.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm sorry about the turbulence.
I can assure you it won't happen again. Because if it does,
I will kill each and every one without hesitation. Do I make myself clear?
Graham, get these two out of here.
Jensen?
Get to work on those explosives.
I want this door open now.
Jerry, are you there? What's going on? Jerry, talk to me. What's going on?
Something's wrong. Get down to the cargo hold, yeah? Find out what's going on.
Jerry's nowhere to be found. I'm sure he's dead.
You down there in the cargo hold.
You take one of mine. I'll take one of yours.
No, 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 no! Shoot me!
How pathetically noble. All in good time, Mr. Scott.
No, no!
Get her out of here.
Sending you down company, Chad. Your friend from the bar.
So talk to him. If you don't bring it up here in 5 seconds, I'm going to put a bullet in this pretty little flight attendant's head.
Five.
Four. Three. Two.
Hold it!
You're the one giving me all these headaches. I believe you have a knife. I'll take that. Give me the knife.
Jeremy. We got company, blue team, east side. So what am I, Superman now?
She took a bullet that was meant for you. So that you can live out your purpose.
The entire world under a single currency, a single leader.
Man, I know you don't understand that, but one day you will. When the time comes, God will reveal his plan for you.
You and that chip are connected, forever linked.
All you have to do is just accept his love with an open heart. He will reveal his plan to you.
Turner. I can't find what I came here for.
Yeah. How's that my problem?
Because I have it on good authority that you have in your possession that which I am looking for.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Sure you do. And if I don't get what I came for, I'm going to start shooting these passengers. Starting with her.
She's not a passenger.
She is now.
All right, wait.
Why? It's in your checked luggage?
It's not in my luggage. It's not on me. It's in me.
Come again?
It's an implant.
It's functioning? Well, that's even better.
What are you gonna do?
What am I gonna do? I'm gonna cut it out. Too bad you killed the only one of us with any kind of medical training.
I wouldn't do that if I were you.
And just who might you be?
I worked with a company that hired Mr. Turner. He's the first completely successful human implant. It won't do you any good to cut him up.
Then I just cut off the whole hand.
That certainly won't work.
What will? What do you mean, nothing?
Chip is biometric. It's fueled by his own blood supply. If you try to remove it in any way, it'll release a deadly neurotoxin, killing him instantly.
Bollocks. You expect me to believe that?
I don't expect anything, but if you do kill him, the chip will shut down, effectively killing itself. Whoever hired you didn't tell you much, huh?
Inspector Plan B. You, watch him. You, get him out of here. Come out!
Captain, are you there?
You said you weren't going to kill anyone else.
That was a separate matter.
You should be more concerned about the other passengers right now. I've got what I came for. You play your cards right, I'll be out of here shortly.
What is it you need me to do?
I need you to descend to 5,000 feet.
All right.
But I can't guarantee what the turbulence will be at that altitude.
Well, then you better stop praying. Get the blankets. Put them over the passenger's head. Get that flight attendant to help you. It's not quite been your day, has it, mate?
All right, put it over your head. Cover yourself up.
Cover yourself up. Come on, come on.
Turner and jumping off the plane. Why do you think we're descending?
But the stewardess said that we...
I don't care what the stewardess said.
For all we know, she's one of them.
What gives you the right to decide to put us all in jeopardy?
I don't know where you've been, buddy, but we're already in jeopardy. Be quiet.
Yeah. Kill the hijackers, take back the plane.
Maybe we should ask other passengers.
Oh, yeah, that's a good idea. Most of these people don't even speak English.
Must feel like a pretty big man killing innocent people.
Hey! Hey! I said no talking!
What's going on?
We're down to 18,000 feet. It's getting bumpy.
Explosives ready.
Cabin door is now rigged with explosives, so don't try anything stupid.
You take me down below 10.
And keep it steady. I got a precious cargo back here.
Hello? Arlo? Arlo?
Where's Arlo?
I don't know.
Well, he doesn't just disappear. Go find him.
Arlo?
Arlo? Where are you? Arlo?
You've got to distract this guy. I've got blood all over me.
Hey, where are you going?
I gotta use the bathroom.
Sit.
Look, if I'm going to die, I don't want to die in the puddle.
I said get back in your seat.
Come on, man. What's the harm?
I said sit back down!
What's going on?
He wants to go to...
He has to go where?
To the bathroom.
He has to go to the bathroom.
I'm sorry. There's your calls.
I'm sorry, too. Thank you.
Captain? Captain, it's Dow. You can open up now. It's all clear. You can open up.
Why don't you try the intercom? I'm gonna go see what's going on with the passengers. Have that coming.
I'll take that for the company. For that chip, Chad. You are nothing. You don't know how lucky you are.
Lucky? I didn't ask for any of it.
Maybe you didn't. But that chip has the power to change the world. It's a symbol of freedom. You are the future of mankind, Mr. Turner.
Nice if I had the choice.
What's going on? Okay, everybody just try to calm down, okay? Calm down. What's going on? What did the captain say?
I couldn't reach him on the intercom.
Is the intercom broken? I mean, what?
It's working.
It's just the clothes left behind. It's like the piles of clothes where people used to be.
Don't understand, but one day you will.
Let me call you Cap.
When the time comes, God will reveal your plan to you. Says, blessed are those who read and hear the prophecy and take it to heart, because the time is near.
It just vanished.
There are dozens of passages missing. How is that possible?
I don't know. Just try to keep these people calm down.
It's the rapture.
I always thought that I was a good enough person with all that I was doing for the Lord. Now, I realize that just doing good does not secure a place for us in heaven. I never fully accepted that. Till now. Even though I preached it for years. God has taken those that believe in him.
We're at a missing passengers.
I want to see the captain.
Wait. What about my husband?
Did he believe in the Bible and its teachings?
Why are you asking me this?
Did he?
He did.
Everybody listen. All we need to worry about is getting this plane safely on the ground. Nothing else. Look, the blast like that could just bring the plane down.
We survived the last blast, didn't we?
We were lucky.
Not only that, there's something else you should know. We're headed back to the car.
Why is that?
That's protocol in emergency situations. I could tell the captain turned the plane back to Bangkok when we tried to retake the plane.
All right, well, how long till we reach Bangkok?
About 30 minutes.
You are wasting time. One thing's for sure, we do nothing as plane goes down.
You don't know that. Come on, the captain could be passed out. He can still come too.
We can't count on that. Our only option is to blow the door.
I got a better suggestion.
We have to act right now. Time is everything. What do you think?
There may be another way.
All right, I'm in.
Okay, look for the door in the forward bulkhead.
I don't see anything.
Okay, well, maybe it got damaged in the blast. Can you feel around? There should be some cold air coming through.
He's coming from over here somewhere.
All right, I got it.
Okay, good. Can you get in?
Looks like the explosion jammed it shut.
Looks like we're gonna have to blow the door after all, like I said.
No, wait. Okay, Chad, listen. There are two seams in the bulkhead, one on either side of the plane. Can you just see if either one of them is torn or ruptured?
Probably gonna need some kind of a crowbar tool of some kind. See if I can find something
there. No. Passengers can't bring anything like that on a plane anymore.
I don't see anything. Do you have any tools up there?
Well, yeah, in the cockpit. Everything we have now is plastic.
Yeah. Even the plastic explosive.
Wait. I got all the tools you need right here. If I can get down there with a couple other strong guys, we'll pull that bulkhead right off the wall if that's what it takes.
He's running out of time.
He's running out of time, and the captain says he's running out of time.
I don't know what else to do. I don't have any more options.
You've had a rough day.
Yeah, sure wasn't what I was expecting when I was shaving this morning.
Yeah, me neither. Hey, I just want to say thanks for everything you've done. You got us this far.
You think that's really what happened? All those folks, that it was the rapture. Those that believe in Jesus Christ were taken, and the rest of us were left behind.
There's no other explanation. It's impossible.
And the only one that can do the impossible is God.
Hey, I have faith we can do this together.
I can use a little faith right now.
Dal, we're going in.
We're gonna do this.
Okay, they can do it.
He's got 10 minutes.
All right, let's get these boxes out of the way. I got an idea.
Between the instrument rack towards the nose, almost all the way to the front of the plane, should be a hatch to the cockpit. On it should be a handle with a latch. Turn it and press upwards.
Has he reached the cockpit yet?
Chad? What's going on down there?
Found the hatch, but it's not budging. You think this thing could be locked from the cockpit? Come in, people. Can you hear me?
I'm going back down there.
Wait. Chad. You're just gonna have to find another way.
We have another way.
Chad, you're running out of time.
Just give me 5 more minutes, okay? 5 more minutes.
What for?
5 minutes, please.
Not a second more.
Okay. All right, Chad. What do you need?
Does anybody up there know what kind of cooling system the avionics runs on?
On the newer planes.
With more advanced electronics, they run liquid cooling systems now.
Possibly liquid nitrogen.
Yeah, gotcha.
Chad, what are you doing?
I'm just gonna try a little college experiment. We got a problem down here.
Chad, what's going on?
I think I found a radio jamming device.
Hey. Whatever he does to not disconnect the liquid nitrogen pumps, okay? Those high-powered CPUs will start to overheat, and they're gonna overtake the plane's entire navigation and guidance systems.
Chad?
3 minutes.
Says whatever you do, don't disconnect the liquid nitrogen pumps. Chad?
Lord, give me the strength
to God! Is everybody okay? Are you okay? Are we okay?
We're gonna blow that door.
Now!
Oh, God. Wait. Chad? Chad, this is Dow. I don't know if you can hear me, but if you can, I just want you to know that we all still believe in you. And you're gonna walk through that door any minute now.
Blow that door,
but if
now!
You can, I'm praying that we're gonna make it through this. I don't know why you're not answering me, but I assume there's a really good reason, and you're gonna walk through that door any minute now. And if you could just...
Chad, you can hear me? I'll blow that door.
No!
Everybody, step back. Step back. Step back behind the partition.
Okay, I've got it set for 2 minutes.
On the count of three. One. Two.
Bombs we can get through.
Not good for you, pal. But I wouldn't be celebrating just yet.
You're freezing.
We still got a plane to land.
Let's do it.
Sure. All right, how's it looking?
Okay, she's okay.
35 people missing from my flight. It's not possible. The time he said that Bangkok is on fire. Tokyo is burning out of control. Looks as swarming through the streets of Singapore.
So it's true. It's really happening. Well, at least we're safe.
No, we're not. We still got a bomb to take care of. There's a bomb attached to an altimeter. And it looks to me as if we go below 3,000 feet, that it's gonna blow. They teach you how to disarm those things in flight attendant school?
Well, they did, actually. I was sick that day.
Why can't we just toss it out? I mean, toss it out of the plane. Is that possible? I mean, what do you think?
Well, in theory, it could work. If I get the plane below 8,000 feet to pressurize the cabin, you go down below, open the rear cargo door, throw it out. By the time we hit 3,000 feet, bomb will be triggered, we'll be miles away.
Can we fly with the door open?
Well, technically, you can land a plane with the door open, so...
Well, I don't think we should let the passengers know, though. They've been through a lot of trauma already.
That's okay. I'll tell them I have to depressurize the plane as a safety precaution before we land because of the explosion.
How are we going to get a bomb down through the passenger cabin without anybody knowing it?
I could take care of that.
Ladies and gentlemen, as a safety precaution, we'll be depressurizing the plane during our descent, so please fasten your seatbelts.
Be right back.
Cheer up, Mr. Turner. You're a part of something that's on the verge of changing the world.
God's work, it feels like something else.
What do you mean?
I know this sounds crazy, but the chip, it's in the Bible. It's the mark of the beast.
Ted, we're in now.
We gotta get this thing out of here before we hit 3,000 feet.
Okay. I'm gonna open the door.
Go ahead and open it up. Hold on.
You two make a good team.
Okay, Ted. The bomb is gone.
What are you doing?
I'm done. I don't want to be a part of any of this anymore.
Doesn't matter what you want. I've got a job to do, and that's to deliver you as planned to the G20 summit.
I'm afraid I can't do that.
You don't have a choice, pal.
You're not gonna shoot me. You need me, and you need the chip.
You're right. I do need you, but I don't need her. You make one false move, I will shoot her. Got it?
Go to shoot town. Both of them.
That one too. I don't want you to get any crazy ideas about jumping.
It's okay. We're okay.
Where do you think you're gonna go? My guys are waiting on the ground. At the airport, on the ramp. You'll never make it off this plane. I've already delivered you. You're just too dumb to realize.
Yeah? You're the one who's all trussed up like a pig on a spit. How are you gonna explain to your boss how that happened to a smart guy like you, huh?
Go ahead, jump. You're chipped. I'll find you. But if you jump, know this. She goes to prison for the rest of her life. She'll be arrested as soon as we land. Aiding and abetting a fugitive, interfering with a federal officer, theft of government property, conspiracy. She'll spend the rest of her life in prison. But if you stay, we're all heroes. We'll be rich.
What happened up here? All those people disappearing. If that was the rapture, then this trip has a whole new meaning. And I'm not gonna let it fall into the wrong hands. I'm out of here.
I'm going with you!
How romantic. You've got one parachute. There's two of them. You jump out there, you'll both die.
Tell the captain we're getting off early.
Ted, you're gonna have to land this thing with the door open. We're getting off early.
I will find you, Mr. Turner. No matter where you run, I will find you, and I will bring you back.
You know what? You were right. We do make a good team. Ready?
You lost them, didn't you?
Global confusion is unfolding at this hour as reports are flooding in from around the world. Tens of thousands of people are missing. Many of them are children and without explanation. Adding to the chaos, a rash of extreme natural disasters has blanketed areas around the world. Reports of tsunamis, earthquakes, violent storms have struck every continent. Governments and scientists have offered no concrete answers, and officials are racing to calm public fears in an attempt to avoid widespread panic.
Yes?
Tell me about this chip.
The Avanti chip is the solution, along with finding a leader. Someone who understands technology, world economics, as well as social and spiritual ramifications.
I've spoken to my advisors. They tell me you know a lot about it.
Why, yes, I do. And if you think I can help, please.
We need you in Berlin.
I understand.
Now.
I leave immediately. See you soon. The dragon stood on the shore of the sea. It has begun.
Why didn't you kill him?
'Cause of what my brother said to me about having a purpose. That moment when I held his life in my hands, it all made sense to me. Don't worry, it's gonna be okay. Looks like we're right over the city.
Look! It's the end of the world!
My brother would have said, it's a new beginning. My brother would have said, have faith.
You do believe in God, don't you?
Personally, I think it's a great situation to make myself a very rich man.
The best option, our only option, is the chip in Chad Turner.
The chip. It's in the Bible. It's the mark of the beast.
So as you know, the target is Chad Turner, ex-US Special Forces. Now courier for prototype biometric chip developed by Avanti. Mr. Turner's a dangerous man. He trained like us. He thinks like us. This is not going to be an easy job. Any questions? Then what are you still doing here?
I need information, people. Anything.
You need to start showing me your worth.
We're working on it. We'll find them.
I need that chip. Do whatever it takes to find the chip. The last attempt to recover the chip on Flight 417 was thwarted by the most unforeseen of events.
Where's Mr. Turner? You were on a plane together. You got away? There's nothing natural about what's happening, I can assure you.
You were on that plane with me, you saw what happened.
You cannot stop the wrath of God.
Have you spoken to God lately? Did he tell you this was his plan?
Disappearing. If that was the rapture, then this chip has a whole new meaning, and I'm not gonna let it fall into the wrong hands.
If he gets a hold of this chip, he can control everyone, he can control the world.
Yourself, kid. Things are happening that you can't even begin to comprehend.